Hi, a warm hello to all the learners, and I again welcome you in my YouTube channel Metamorphosis. And we are continuing with the M.H. Abrams series, and today I have taken a very important point, that is theater or literature of the absurd, which is, you know, the first topic in M.H. Abrams, and it's supposed to be very crucial from the point of view of exams. So let us start without wasting time, that what is literature of the absurd. So let me narrate one story which is a real life story, and it happened in France when Samuel Beckett was going to a morning walk, and a person, a youngster or a teenager, came from the back and he stabbed Samuel Beckett. And when he opened his eyes in the hospital and he asked the person that, why did you stab me, do you know me? So he answered that, actually I was feeling like to stab somebody, and I found you, the first person there on the road, and I stabbed you. This was quite stunning for Samuel Beckett, who was supposed to be a genius of that century, 20th century. And then Samuel Beckett started thinking that, is that life of the human being is so meaningless? Are we doing all the things or the work or activities in the world without any of the consequences, proper consequences? Or are we so meaningless that we don't even give second thought to something which we are thinking to do? So from here he started thinking of that absurdism, though absurdism was quite a kind of ancient term where the roots lie somewhere else. So let us start exploring absurdism from the very beginning. The first question which may be asked in exam, that from where this came or who coined the term. So Martin Esslin is the person who coined the term absurd, or absurd literature, or absurd, which was later refined as absurd drama also, but absurd term was used by Martin Esslin. And the term absurd itself explains something, and that is, it is a common view that the human condition essentially absurd. Means in the work of prose, poetry or drama, if we see that human condition is essentially absurd, meaningless, where we don't find any meaning. So here we find that this is actually what we mean by absurd, where we find that the human life is meaningless and condition is also meaningless. The roots of the absurdism is very important, that from where it starts originating. You know, it has first marked its appearance in 1896 when Alfred Gerry wrote Ubu Roy. It means Ubu the king. Here we find a little tint of absurdism, and then afterwards some of the movements which gave it a push, which gave it, you know, a stimulating experience, that was one of that 20th century movement, modern world, avant-garde movement, expressionism, surrealism. Both movements are related with the painting at first, then they came into literature. And of course French Kafka's two great work, The Trial and The Metamorphosis, and one of the most important movement, existentialism. So I will brief, because they are a great movement, so I will brief in order to understand that what is expressionism. The expressionism was a painting movement where Vincent van Gogh is supposed to be the great painter who painted the paintings like The Sunflowers, Starry Nights, on which a great song was also made or performed by Don McLean, Starry Starry Nights. And in this, they used to paint the abstract expression which they used to feel. And this from painting came to the literature in avant-garde movement in 20th century. Surrealism, the major figure being Salvador Dali, who used to paint the borderline of the conscious and subconscious mind, where all the impressions which they feel like in that condition, where the subconscious and conscious actually meets, or where the border of that is there. And French Kafka, The Trial and Metamorphosis, they are supposed to be great absurd literature novel or absurd novels, where some kind of elements of magic realism also are there, when Gregor Samsa's in Metamorphosis suddenly turns into a different type of creature. But the most important moment which pushed it greatly was existentialism. Existentialism is propagated by great figure Jean-Paul Sartre in France, and he told that human being in this world is casted into an alien universe when he comes there, and throughout his life he tried to find whole of his life the meaning of his existence or the meaning of his being born here, the significance of his being born here. And in that he tried to prove his existence, but he always find it meaningless, and one very fine day he dies and he goes without any existence. And Jean-Paul Sartre is supposed to bring this philosophy, which actually was a great philosophy. Jean-Paul Sartre is that figure who does not even accepted Nobel Prize. He didn't take the Nobel Prize even. He is famous for that also. And you know, this is the way, why that's the way the meaninglessness or the meaninglessness of the literature or everything creeps into literature. And then in current movement, when it came in contemporary time period, it started in France, and they said that it was a reaction against traditional belief, that people used to believe that human beings are fairly rational creatures who live in at least partially intelligible universe, and they are the part of social structure, and they are capable of heroism, means they can even perform heroic deeds even after defeat. This was the opinion before the World War II. But after the horrors of World War II and the experiences of the World War II, this whole belief was shattered into parts. And then suddenly this came that this life is actually meaningless. And that's how the current movement started. Eugene Ionesco, one of the great genius of the France, he also gave a famous remark that cut from his metaphysical and transcendental roots, a man is nothing. A man loses his identity. This also actually indicates the meaninglessness of the man's life. Then it came in modern literature when Samuel Beckett writes his Waiting for Godot in 1954, where a famous remark is there, nothing happens, nobody comes, nobody goes, it's awful. So in Waiting for Godot, we see that two tramps, one Vladimir is an Estragon, they are waiting for somebody, and they say to each other that we are waiting for Godot, but nobody comes and nobody goes. Only Lucky and Pozzo comes there, and Lucky's speech, as the, you know, mini narratives in English literature are very famous, which is one of the most prominent feature of the modern world or modern literature. And the same way, Samuel Beckett continued to write in the same stream, and he wrote The End Game, a famous novel. And after Samuel Beckett, this movement actually added some more part in that, and that another part is, with absurdism there came diabolism. Diabolism is a kind of, you know, sharpness in intensity of reality, or you can say that harsh reality, or you can say somehow more poisonous than that. And diabolism is added to that, which actually made literature or framed literature towards the black comedy or black humor, where the characters are baleful, naive, inept characters. And Eugene Ionesco say that, he also gives a new name, that it is also called tragic farce. And this tradition continued with the modern writers also. And two famous novels are asked, that Thomas Pynchon's one novel is V, or which is the in Roman number we write it 5, and one is Joseph Heller's Catch 22. They both are very important from the point of view of text also. I would suggest NET aspirants to go through the text also of these books. So this is all about the theater of the absurd. And later, Harold Pinter, The Birthday Party, and you know, Rosenkranz and Guildenstern are dead from the Tom Stoppard, who is also one of the person who is responsible for writing a script, you know, or a screenplay, right, in the film Shakespeare in Love in Hollywood. And this question was also asked in NET, that who wrote the screenplay in the famous film, which won Oscar award also, Shakespeare in love. So Tom Stoppard and Harold Pinter, they also continued with the same tradition, and you all know that rest is the history, that how great writers they are in this particular genre. So I think, students, this is the introductory part of the literature of the absurd, and I try to give the roots, the major writers, the major work and the philosophy behind it, and I think that I could justify it. If you have another demand, you can write in the inbox or in the text. And thanks, have a nice day, and we'll be in next video discussing some more good and interesting topic. Please keep liking, subscribing. Till then, good day.